Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. Okay, I wanted to share. These are all my snippets that I have been creating. I've been going crazy, I'm telling you. But I use them just as fast as I make them. This one, not so much, but I'm going to start pretty soon. But, yeah. Okay. I think I showed this one before, but it's just all color bits. Isn't that gorgeous? Absolutely gorgeous. Okay, so I have that one. And then I have this one. It's just the same all the way down. All I did was cut pieces of that little girl's leotard that I found at my thrift store. I just cut little tiny squares and just sewed them. Isn't that gorgeous? So I have that. Let me put them back in the bag. Save time. Okay, and then I have this one. This one I just did using fibers. You know, I picked one or two fibers. And no, actually, I just did one. Yeah, I did one fiber. And I have this fabric that Gail gave me. It's like a multicolor fabric, and I tore it in strips, and then I just added one fiber that's a multicolor fiber to it, and it has these little fuzzies. See? Gorgeous. And they just change color with the color of the fabric, and I just zigzagged it on there. So see, even that side looks good, the back side. So yeah, I made a huge one of this one. Then I did this one also with seam binding and some of my fiber that's in my store, and then just some other different fibers. And what I did was I kind of braided it, and then just zigzagged it, zigzagged the braid. And then this fiber has like these little bits that are dangling, you know? So pretty. Oh, I just love it. So that's that one. And then I did this one, and again, it is I used black thread. It's just a piece of like muslin in the back. And two fibers mixed together. The white one and then this multicolored one. Isn't that pretty? Oh, and it just made this whole roll. And then I did this one. And it's just a piece of lace with the multicolor fibers. And then I used eyelash, two different eyelashes. And then I added fuzzy. And then I added this crazy curly Q kind of, it's like upholstery cording, and I just pulled it apart. So I made that one. And I think I've shown a few of these before. And then this one, again, is just a... Well, these are just pieces, so that I need to work on this one. But see, that's... They're just torn pieces of fabric. Skinny pieces. And then I just sewed some fuzzy fiber on it. And again, zigzag. Oh, just so pretty. So, there's that one. And give me just a sec to wrap it up here. That way I can put it away. But I've been using so much of this that I'm gonna make this roll next. And then I'm gonna use Deb's two rolls that she just gave me. But then I have this one. And this one I have a couple pins holding it because there's pieces that I've used. Look at that one. This is all fuzzy. You know, just your threads. You know, like this stuff. All different kinds of threads. That's what I sewed on here. Look at that. Oh, camera. There we go. Just this. Different colors. So I've already used a lot of that one. and then, oh, let me put that there. And then there's this one. More fuzzy. And just a couple bits of fabric. And then there's this one. Aren't they so stinking gorgeous? Oh, I just love them. There's this one. Super cool. And then this one. There's that one. And this one is more on cream and beige and white. And then this one has pink and tea dye and coffee dye. So pretty. Super, super pretty. So there you go, Rosie. I had a request to show these in more detail, so I hope you were able to see them, sweetheart. And that way she can get an idea. I think she wants to make some. Rosie is my friend in Orange County. She doesn't do YouTube videos. But I wanted her to see so she can get more of an idea of, you know, how they look. So she can do some. So, those are my little scrappy rolls that I will use for projects. And definitely we'll see. Sorry, I'm sneezing. You definitely will see more projects very soon using either these shabby chic ones or the colorful ones. And like I say, I've been using them and making them, and I'm loving creating stuff with these. Lots of things I don't do videos on. I just don't have time. I need to, you know, make them and move on to the next. Okay, so, let me see. Do I have time? Yes, I do. Okay, I wanted to show a couple of other things that I was doing. I guess it's going to be like a this and that kind of video. Trying to look here. Okay. Let me grab. I have also made two more like snippet rolls. That I completed, so I want to show these. Well, this is one. Where was the other one? The other one. Oh, okay. I see the other one. Okay, let me show you this one first. So, I just made a little bag. I'm not done yet. You know, just fiber. That's part of that snippet fiber I made. And just sewed the bag and put the, you know, put that piece of trim there. And then this is in my store, this huge fuzzy. Oh, I love it. And actually, I've made some flowers with this. I don't know where they are. Oh, I made them for Siobhan. That's what I did. I used this and I just twisted like this and glued it together. And then put a bling in the center, and it makes the most gorgeous little poofy flower. But this I used for the tie. And I always like to find different ways of doing snippet rolls. So this one, because this was so wide, I used it for the tie, and that way she can hang it. Person who's going to receive this can hang it, right? You can tie it and hang it, or she can roll it up like a regular snippet roll, which I'll do at the end here, and tie it with these. So this is, everything is sewn on, so she can take everything off. Little flowers, and there's a little flower there with this. See, I just cut like a little end, and it's a little ball, right? It's a little fuzzy ball, cute flower. This is just little pearls and little laces and flowers and so on, beads and a pin with these little bits, and there's pearls, buttons, and then the rosette, And then on this side, I've got, some appliques, some little doily bits, a little bit of coffee dyed lace there, a little angel or fairy applique, and these I used the black thread so you could see where to pull it off if you want. Some lace. And that's the other end. And then all you have to do, of course, everybody knows, is... Oops, I want to wrap it the other way. Wrap it this way. I like everything on the inside, so it doesn't get snagged. Okay, but see, it just wraps. And then you can just tie it up. With the big fuzzy bow. There we go. Big fuzzy bow. I don't know which way it looks better, but anyway, there we go. That's that one. And then let me see if I can reach my other one. I think I have to go around the desk. One moment, please. It's behind everything. Yep. Okay, here we go. Okay, so there's that one. And then there's this one. And this one I used seam binding and lace, vintage lace for the tie. And I don't know if I showed this one or not, but I want to make sure that I do show it. So this is just a silk flower pansy, and then that's a piece of lace, a flower that was on a lace that I used for the center. And then this is just little, that was part of a sleeve, and just little bits. Little metal pieces. That was a little bead that I made. Oh no, that was a button I covered. Yeah. That was a button that I covered with lace. This one is a wooden piece that I painted. It was kind of green, like really, really green. But I toned it down a little bit, and then I layered tulle on top of it. I don't know if it will focus. There you go. See? So I tucked it under tulle. And it's a little horseshoe and fuzzy. And just a little piece of a bracelet or earring or something. More pieces of like broken jewelry there. This was an earring. More jewelry. That was just a little tiny scrap from a dress or a bra that Gail gave me. It had a little bit of bead there. I couldn't throw it away. So it ended up on that snippet roll. That one too. Just a tiny little piece of something with beads on it that I had to just, let's see, will it focus? Is it going to focus? Put the ring there. It loves my ring. There we go. Right there. Little tiny beads. And then a sew-on bling. And that was a little scrap. A little, I don't know. Must have been a trim of some sort. A little dangle trim. An earring, and just a little cut of a snippet with some threads, and then the back, it's just vintage lace, and that's a piece of lace that I cut the flower from, and a leaf, my favorite, more lace, a little bit there, lace. And that's that one. So I'll just kind of hold it still. Okay. So, yeah, I hope that you liked these. And I will be back with, another project share very soon. Thank you so much, guys. Love you. Stay tuned. Thanks for all your comments. And God bless everyone.